And the answer in this case is no. And the reason for this is because this code is unreachable. This is dead code. Because no matter the value of j, this condition will always be false because I will always be zero. And notice that this is a small example, but another important truth is that any non-trivial program contains dead or unreachable code. Code that no matter how well we test our system, we will never be able to exercise. Why is that? Various reasons. For example, defensive programming, or for example, developing for future releases. So there might be pieces of code that are added, but they're still not activated. They're still not invoked by any other part of the code. Because of modifications to the code, there are some parts that were executed before, and in the new version of the program, they're no longer exercised. They're no longer executable, but they still remain in the code base. And this is a very, very normal situation for these reasons and many more. And this is an important concept because this affects the very meaning of coverage measures. If there is some unreachable code, we will never be able to reach 100% code coverage. And in fact, if you remember at the beginning of the lesson, we discussed this concept and asked you why you think that in industry, the target for coverage is not 100%, but less than that. And that's the answer. To account for the fact that there are infeasibility problems that I have to take into account when I test the code. Infeasible paths, unexecutable statements, conditions that can never be true, and so on. So most criteria, if not all, are affected, and we need to take that into account when we try to achieve a given coverage target.